chance to give away the threesomes there. Dimitrios Karapidis, Francesco Batella, and Apostolos Zousis in the S1 class. Curtis Lovejoy of America and David McClopper, South Africa, swimming in the S2 classification. They will be matching up against the swimmers in our next race, swimming in the heat for that final, which will come up later on this evening. So two Greeks and an Italian competing for the three medals in the S1 100 metre backstroke.
Real contrast between the two S2 swimmers. David McClopper making his international debut. He's coached by South African Paralympic legendary swimmer Tadeusz Slattery. He was a Paralympic champion back in the 90s. And great influence on the young 16-year-old David McClopper. He's up against 60-year-old Curtis Lovejoy, who is one of the oldest competitors here. Sebastian Rodriguez and Curtis Lovejoy, both 60 years of age and still competing at the major championships. This is the S1 and S2 classifications, of course. The S1 being swimmers with the most impairment in the Paralympic program. All of these S1 swimmers affected in all four limbs, with limited movement in their limbs. Francesco Batella has been the class act of this field already, with a gold medal to his name this week. Two Greek swimmers just making their way over to the start. Better of the Italian. It's not going to be easy. The Italian very much the favourite for this one. The S1 class, again, we see techniques developed throughout the years, and the technique of holding the swimmers in position, certainly in these lower classifications, is something that has developed over the years. It has become kind of standard way of starting now. Someone just came up with the technique, it's seen at the major championships, and suddenly other countries thought, oh right, let's try that, see if it works for our swimmers. And it has become one of the standard methods of starting. Of course, the swimmers allowed to be held in place by their coaching staff. The coaching staff not allowed to add propulsion. As soon as the starting signal goes, swimmers are released away and racing. Curtis Lovejoy leads the race here. He's in the S2 class. He's in a heat with David McClopper, just one lane up. Battle for the medals are three lanes down from Curtis Lovejoy and Francesco Batella from Italy. He's leading that contest at the moment. Looks like Karapidis from Greece in lane number two is in second position ahead of his countrymate Tosawas.
Yeah, really good start this from Batella. And you sometimes see this in multi-class paraswimming. You know someone's having a good race if they're up on the classification above them. And that's exactly what Batella is managing to do here. The Italian S1 swimmer leading out both S2 swimmers, Curtis Lovejoy and David McClopper. They aren't competing in the same race, essentially. Lovejoy and McClopper matching up with those in the next race to qualify through to the S2 final. This is the S1 final. And Francesco Batella of Italy is very much making it his own. Going along very nicely indeed is the Italian in lane three. Both arms propelling him backwards towards that wall. Underneath the flags he'll go. And at that point he'll know he is just a few seconds away from gold medal glory. Francesco Vitella takes the gold medal. Another gold medal for Italy. In 2:30.69. Coach Ludwig for the United States of America touches in 10 seconds behind him in the S2 heat. And we're going to have a little bit of a wait here to see the rest of our swimmers. They're the Italian fans, they look pretty happy. And well, they might. They've had plenty to celebrate this week. There is Ioannis Francesco Vitella of Italy. And then coming in lane two now is the Greek Dimitrios Kalapidis, who will grab himself a silver medal. Familiar face on the international scene, Kalapidis. And he grabs himself another medal in the S1 class. Coming on top of your picture, David McCropper in the S2 heat. And with about 15 metres to go still, is Apostolos Sousis in to claim a bronze medal in the S1 final. And there's your winner, an impressive swim from Vitella.
Not too far away from the championship record. 2:30.69 for Vitella. This event only been swum once before at the World Championships. It was won in 2:29.82, so less than a second outside the championship record for the Italian swimmer Vitella. Three swimmers there at the bottom of your picture in the S1 class. There's Lovejoy. There at the finish is Vitella, taking that gold for Italy, his second gold of the week. Takes the acclaim of the crowd and his teammates. Curtis Lovejoy, first home in the S2 class. Should qualify him for the final this evening. As there is only seven swimmers due to take the start for the second heat. Francesco Vitella takes the gold in the S1 classification ahead of Dimitrios Kalapidis and Apostolos Sousis. Greece, silver and bronze.
Yeah, some really nice swims in that race. A couple of medals for Greece. Oops, and that as well in our next race. Remember, this next one will be a heat. We saw two S2 swimmers, Lovejoy and Cropper, compete there.